What's up? Welcome on Section 51. This is Dose Geek for a new video about mysteries, about unexplained stories, all the subjects that trigger us continually. All these subjects, which are very interesting and are surrounding us permanently, especially on the web. So thank you again for supporting us, for watching the videos of Section 51, and now we are going into a new subject. This is the subject of a large extraterrestrial object which interacted with the sun to avoid a big solar storm heading to Earth right now. Okay, we are on the website newsintact.com, and so this is about ancient files. I like this website because the titles are always very entertaining. The titles are telling stories. So, a new article published on September 14th, 2020, UFOlogists are rarely shocked when it comes to new discoveries, as most of what's being discovered or reported these days is pretty standard stuff. But when the announcement comes from NASA themselves, needless to say, it gets pretty hard to maintain your composure past this point. So look at these pictures. You can see this one is here. We zoomed in and you can see a disc shaped like a mothership. Not a fathership, a mothership. So when they went out in front of all the cameras to declare that a huge extraterrestrial UFO interacted with the sun to avoid a big solar storm, we are all listening closely, to say the least. According to them, when it was first spotted, the team figured that the spacecraft was heading towards them with ill intents, so they were extremely scared as they were caught by surprise. But it quickly became clear that they were not the target at this time around. As you can see from the pictures, the event took place somewhere between the sun and Earth, with the images being taken and saved by the space probes around Earth. The really annoying part about it all, however, is the fact that SOHO shut down all six of the solar observatories around the world so that they can make sure that none of this information leaks any further. So we have the video. What is the channel?
A huge extraterrestrial object interacted with the sun to avoid a powerful solar storm, or solar...
This is a video on UFO mania. The truth is out there, okay?
At least you're seeing what's out there right now, and you know, you can let it sink in and come to terms with what's out there, and hopefully it'll help you along. Okay, we're going to end it right there, but this is what I caught this morning facing the eastern sky with the sun. All I could see is it was, as of now, it's probably around 800 now, and there's way too many to go through. And when I just accept certain people, I don't know who I'm accepting, and that's when I get these bad comments that I get on here anyway. But you know what? It's not going to stop me. Okay, I'm still going to take pictures, and I'm just tune them out. You know, this is bigger than them. Okay, I am beyond that. All right, let's flip this around, and we're going to end it right there. But this is what I caught this morning, facing the eastern sky with the sun. All I could see is it was the sun and the sky with the clouds. But I just turned on my flash. I took the picture and went through it, and this is what happened. Okay, yes.
Gina Maria Colvin Hill, who is explaining what is happening on the pictures.
Gigantic and metallic object next to the sun? Is this one of the reasons for the evacuation of the solar observatory in New Mexico? Gina Maria Colvin Hill made this astonishing discovery. Here is what she says. September 12, 2018, 8:22 a.m. Salem, Indiana. I have a little more pictures on the left side of the egg-shaped object and all the ships. Are there more things of spiral/frequency attached to the planet/spacecraft? The photos are on my timeline. See some images below and click on them to enlarge. Are we facing a gigantic mothership? Please visit Gina Maria Colvin Hill Facebook page for more information following a link below this video and draw your own conclusions.
All the particles in space are ships, are spaceships? I'm not so sure. Let's go to another article in order to make our own opinion about the subject. And we are on the express.co.uk, another web media which is a big reference on the web on the subject in the field of ufology, you know. So, alien life proof: NASA video shows planet-sized UFO survive huge solar explosion, and it was ever published, as you can see, on July the 19th of 2019. A planet-sized UFO hovered by the sun before being hit by and surviving a massive solar explosion, according to analysis of NASA video from a self-described UFO expert. I'm curious to know who is the UFO expert, and I am thinking that I didn't see, I didn't check the date of the publication of the video on UFO Mania, and it was published on September 2018, so it was 2 years ago, okay? So the article is written by James Bickerton. The video was recorded by NASA's Solar and Heliospheric Observatory. It appears to show a large stationary object near the sun being hit by a solar flare. However, the object doesn't appear to move or sustain any damage following the strike. I guess this is here. The shape, the strange shape, which is triggering the UFO expert's mind. Speaking to International Business Times, Scott Waring. Ah, yes, we are back with Scott Waring. Scott Waring is back. A blogger specializing in UFOs claimed only part of the mystery object is visible because of its orientation. He believes this proves the sun is hollow and contains planets holding alien civilizations. Mr. Waring added that he had previously seen footage of an object five times the size of Earth leaving the sun. Woo! This is going very, very far, okay? The theory. Advocates of the hollow sun conspiracy theory believe whole systems of planets are contained inside the sun, holding a wide range of alien life. According to the theory, these aliens enter and exit the sun via a giant door-like device on its surface. However, these claims are widely regarded as nonsense within established scientific communities. On his blog, Mr. Waring bizarrely argued the truth about UFOs is being covered up by the American government and NASA. He wrote,
"It's amazing that so many videos of UFOs exist, and yet the US government won't take any of it seriously. Which means they are deliberate hiding the truth from the public."
Respected scientists have yet to find proof that any advanced alien civilizations exist, but many believe they could be established somewhere in the universe. Before his death last year, physicist Stephen Hawking argued alien life could pose an existential threat to human civilization. And we have talked about this in a previous video. I invite you to check the channel section 51. I'm sure that you will find the good video, the good one. Speaking on the Discovery Channel, he warned, Stephen Hawking warned,
"If aliens ever visit us, I think the outcome would be much as when Christopher Columbus first landed in America, which didn't turn out very well for Native Americans. If aliens ever visit us, I think the outcome would be much as when Christopher Columbus first landed in America, which didn't turn out very well for Native Americans."
That's very strong speech. Yes, it has a round shape. It looks like an arc. But pretending that it could be a huge alien mothership traveling through the sun as space-time gate or door, Stargate. That's a theory that's going very too far. That's going too far, I believe. And you, what do you think of this new theory that a huge UFO, a huge extraterrestrial object, could have been interacted with the sun? Do you think that aliens could have a lot of spaceships near the sun? Do you think that they travel through space and time thanks to the sun? Please give us your opinion about this. You can see by reading all these articles that we have a lot of theories, a lot of claims on the internet about all these subjects. So, of course, they are very lovely titles, very entertaining, but when you are digging, when you are going deep inside the article, when you read all the descriptions, the text, the informations, you can see very quickly that there is not so much substance, not so much consistency in all these informations, and that the major part of this news, these UFO news, these amazing news, the major part is not very serious, not all the time. These are articles just to make buzz, to attract traffic on the website. That's a shame, because I'm sure that Scott Waring, who is claiming that he is a UFO expert, I'm sure that he's doing a lot of work and a lot of serious work, that he is passionate with the subject. And I'm sure that there is something that is true in all these stories, that maybe... I love the idea that a huge spaceship, an alien mothership, could be hiding near the sun, or could be cruising near the sun, maybe taking some plasma from the sun in order to produce some energy for long time travel, for interstellar travel. I don't know. I would love the idea of an alien fleet, a fleet of alien spaceships in space, hiding near the sun, ready to invade Earth. That would be a very good scenario, very good story for a movie. But I'm not convinced that all of this is true. So guys, what do you think of this? Do you think that a part of this, even a few part of these stories, is true? Do you think that do you have theories? Do you have your theory about all this? So thank you guys for watching. I hope that you liked this new video. I will see you in the next video very soon about another subject, always, as you can see, in the field of ufology, about unexplained mysteries, the mysteries of the universe, or mysteries of on Earth. You know now all the subjects that trigger my mind. I don't know. I'm still looking now. After 40 years, I'm still looking for understanding what is passing, what is going on in my mind. So, waiting for the next video, you can also check the new CGI videos coming very soon on the channel. This was Dos Geek on Section 51. Of course, live long and prosper. Don't forget to keep watching at the sky, to keep your eyes open, to keep your mind open. Read some books, read some articles about all these subjects on the internet or in other on other supports. I see you very soon on Section 51 on YouTube. I send you big kisses and see you in a new video. Bye. Yeah.